Alright, you saw the title, so let's not beat around the bush. Dawn FM isn't a bad album. I'd even go as far to say it's a good album, but also The Weeknd's least interesting album so far. If you've watched my channel before, you probably know how much I love The Weeknd. I think that mix of his angelic voice, cinematic production, and authentic storytelling makes his music addictive for me, even if sometimes I can't relate to exactly what he's talking about. That said, before listening to this new project, I made sure to check my expectations at the door. I wasn't a huge fan of Take My Breath. As a first single, I didn't think it was nearly as fresh as Starboy or Heartless, but nonetheless, I was excited to see how Weeknd would improve his 80s-inspired sound from After Hours. Now, the album gets off to an excellent start with Gasoline. On my first listen, when Weeknd came in with that lower voice, I was like, holy shit, he's actually gonna reinvent himself again.
It's 5 a.m. my time again, I've soaking up the moon, can't sleep.
Unfortunately, this was probably the most out there moment the album ever had. I mean, the production is very detailed, but still, nothing we haven't heard from Weeknd before. Really, what I liked most about this song was the whole wrap my body in these sheets and pour out the gasoline. It's such a vivid way to describe Weeknd just wanting to get rid of himself. Like, it's not enough that he's dead, but his body has to be completely destroyed. On such an upbeat song, that really caught me off guard. Where my problems with this album really start to rear their head though, is on the next song, How Do I Make You Love Me? I don't think this song is unbearable or anything, but the chorus is so repetitive that it gets old pretty fast. How do I make you love me? How do I make you fall for me? How do I make you want me? And then it's repeated another 3 times. Like, I get it, Weeknd, you want to smash. A lot of the other tracks on the album also fall into this trap of the chorus being just the song title sung over and over again, such as Don't Break My Heart and I Heard You're Married. This wouldn't bother me as much if the verses were pulling their weight, but they're seriously lackluster. First off, only a couple songs have more than 2 of them, and second, they're almost always extremely short and empty. Even if you love all the tracks I've mentioned, ask yourself, are the verses ever what grips you about them? Now you could say, but Mintrom, maybe Weeknd just wanted to make a fun album with less emphasis on songwriting. Sure, but then how do you explain the interludes or the cover art? This is a concept album, so I think it's reasonable for me to expect more from the lyrics. I actually think the old person makeup thing is really cool. I guess it's meant to represent how Weeknd feels old inside because of all his regret. On that note, the Jim Carrey skits are probably the most unique aspect Dawn FM has going for it. Basically, he's playing a radio host who's guiding you to the afterlife.
You are now listening to 103.5 Dawn FM. You've been in the dark for way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms.
As the album progresses, you're told that you're heading towards the light and you're about to be freed from all pain. However, when you reach the final track, Phantom Regret, you learn that you have to find heaven in yourself to be at peace. It's a nice subversion of expectations. The thing is though, these skits feel very disconnected from the actual songs. Weeknd himself doesn't sound like he's heading towards the light. You look at the start of the album with Gasoline, and it's Weeknd singing about how he's a degenerate. And then you look at Less Than Zero, and he's still in the same place. Like, I get that the album is a perfect loop, and I get it's meant to be set in a purgatory state where nothing changes, but wasn't that what After Hours was all about? Weeknd realizing he can't escape from his old ways? That's the thing. So much of Dawn FM is a retread of older Weeknd songs, but not as good. He's done the whole player who gets heartbroken thing one too many times now. Seriously, I have no intention of ever listening to a song like Best Friends again, because it's just a safer version of Often, where Weeknd's talking about a no strings attached relationship. So I know what I'm saying sounds really negative, but there are a decent amount of highlights on here. Sacrifice and Is There Someone Else are absolute bangers, but the album peaks for me around the middle with Out of Time. The song is exactly what Regret feels like, and Weeknd approaches it with much more maturity than he ever has before. He's singing about how past trauma can affect present relationships, and the Quincy Jones interlude that comes before is such a heartfelt setup for that theme. It sounds like it just came out of a conversation he was having with Abel in the studio. Here We Go Again with Tyler continues this more introspective tone, but then we get Best Friends and the album pretty much becomes cliche Weeknd after that. Again, it's not bad, but I just wanted more of those new ideas. I wanted more of Weeknd reflecting on his past and trying to improve himself. Not just, hey girl, why don't you leave your man for me? Speaking of new ideas, I think the production on Weeknd's albums is insanely underappreciated. He's always been one step ahead of the game. There aren't any other songs like Glass Table Girls, The Hills, or Starboy, and I think with Blinding Lights, his influence on pop music became more obvious than ever. The production on Dawn FM, though, is somewhat of a step backwards. Like I said at the start, I don't mind that Weeknd is continuing to use this 80s sound, but most of these songs hit the same spot for me as After Hours. A perfect example is Less Than Zero. It's a solid song by itself, but as the final song, it's very anticlimactic. When I first heard it, I was like, this is just Save Your Tears, but worse. From the instrumentation, tempo, even down to the lyrics, which are about how Weeknd feels he's not good enough for this girl. Also, these songs are very much what you see is what you get. When the verses aren't doing anything and the production doesn't evolve throughout the song, all I'm left with is if I like the initial idea. So for Sacrifice, that's fine, because the beat and Weeknd's vocal melodies are enough for me to stay engaged. But then you get something like I Heard You're Married, and because that instrumental gets old after about a minute, I lose interest. Overall, this album definitely feels like more of a transition from After Hours into whatever Weeknd's next project is, rather than a grand statement on its own. I guess in that sense, it's very similar to My Dear Melancholy. The difference is though that Dawn FM is almost an hour long, and Melancholy was just a 20-minute EP. Coming off After Hours, I was so interested to see where Weeknd would go next. The last song on that album, Until I Bleed Out, really felt like him at rock bottom. His life couldn't get any lower, and the only place to go was up. But Dawn FM is just a return to the status quo for Weeknd. He's still getting heartbroken, and I'm getting tired.